Moscow says it has brought some 700,000 children from the conflict zones in Ukraine into Russian territory. A Russian Federation Council official said these children were fleeing the bombing in conflict areas in Ukraine and were given refuge in Russia. Moscow has said its program of bringing Ukrainian children into Russia is meant to protect orphans in the conflict zone. But Ukraine said many children have been deported illegally and forcibly removed from their homes. At least one is killed after Israeli forces launched an airstrike in West Bank city of Yenin Sunday evening. Another person was injured. Israel's military said it hit a command center for militant fighters in Jenin, but residents said the missile destroyed a house. Israeli forces have conducted regular air raids there, where Palestinian militant groups, including Hamas and the Islamic Jihad, have hundreds of armed fighters. Filipinos leaving their marks in the world of sports. Star vaulter EJ Obiena secured a spot in the 2024 Summer Olympics in Paris after clearing the qualification standard of 5.82 meters in the Bauhaus-Skalen meet in Sweden. Meanwhile, billiards aces James Aranes and Johan Chua gave the Philippines its fourth title in the World Cup of Pool. For more on these stories, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. Attackers in France rammed a car and tried to set on fire the home of a mayor in southern Paris. L'Île-et-Rose mayor Von Zond Zanbron said he was not at home during that incident. His wife and children, however, were asleep inside that house and were attacked and injured as they fled the scene. A probe is underway. The incident comes amid the unrest in the country following last week's shooting of a teenager by a police officer.
There is no doubt at all they wanted to burn the house, and in fact, from the moment they understood there was someone inside, since some lights got switched on, far from stopping, on the contrary, they unleashed a salvo of mortar fire that was completely crazy.
Now at least two are dead in a mass shooting at a block party in Baltimore, Maryland. 28 others are wounded, half of whom are children. Some are in critical condition. Authorities are still searching for multiple suspects. The tragedy rattled the city of Baltimore at the start of the 4th of July holiday weekend, when Americans typically gather for parades and fireworks.
This is insanity. This cannot be the society that we are expected to live in. We have to do better. We've done what we could at the state level to try and find ways for it to be harder to get guns into people's hands, but this is the problem with too many guns in too many hands of people that make life and death decisions. It is not okay. Something has to give.
Advertising agency DDB Philippines apologizing over its use of non-original and stock footage of other countries in the tourism department's video for its new slogan, Love the Philippines. It says the presentation was meant to be a mood video to excite internal stakeholders about the campaign, adding no public funds were used for it. The agency also calls its use of stock footage an unfortunate oversight, highly inappropriate and contradictory to the tourism department's objectives. Albay Representative Joey Salcedo also weighing in on the tourism ad campaign mess. He says this proves the lousy work done on the new tourism campaign of the Philippine government. Salcedo also saying plagiarism cannot set the mood in tourism ads of the country. Salcedo earlier called out the tourism department for failing to include Albay's Mayon volcano in the country's latest marketing campaign. With an update on Mayon volcano's unrest, states volcanologists warning residents within the volcano's 7 to 8 kilometer danger zone to prepare for possible evacuation. Our very own Irene Perol now joins us with details. Irene, over to you.
Carmina, Mayon volcano's activity this morning was due to the collapse of the lava dome, which resulted to pyroclastic density current, according to Philippine Institute of Volcanology and Seismology. In some photos taken and shared by netizens early this morning, Mayon volcano is seen with a cauliflower-like plume above it and appears to have exploded. But according to Dr. Paul Alanis, resident volcanologist of FIVOX Legazpi City, they have not observed or detected any explosion yet since the onset of the volcano's activity first week of June this year, though it is on a quiet eruptive stage. The latest activity around 7 o'clock this morning was a dome collapse with fragments of hot rock lava falling towards the direction of Basu Channel in Santo Domingo, Albay. But due to the strong wind at the time of the lava dome collapse, the volcanic plume was driven to Ginobatan and Ligao areas, which could possibly lead to ashfall in the said municipalities. Alert level 3 remains around Mayon Volcano, and those living in the extended 7 to 8 kilometers danger zone are advised to be prepared for evacuation anytime.
Kumahaba po yung mga lumalayo yung mga pyroclastic density current, umabot po ng 4 kilometers ang haba. Particularly dito sa bandang south and southeast ng Mayon Volcano.
Mm-mm.
So pinaalalahanin natin ating mga kababayan na nakatira sa 7 and 8 kilometer boundary na magandang mag-evacuate kinakailangan.
Meanwhile, a total of 6,183 families or 21,741 persons are displaced from 7 municipalities in Albay due to the current alert level status of Mayon Volcano.
The Philippine National Police Anti-Cybercrime Group says four Chinese fugitives were among the persons arrested in a raid in Las Piñas last week. Authorities, though, did not provide additional details. The PNP is currently in the process of filing charges against several hundred foreign workers and local contacts apprehended in the sweep at a Philippine offshore gaming operator center. The PNP said it also prevented an escape attempt by several foreigners. Meanwhile, a lawyer for some of the apprehended individuals has decried the alleged maltreatment by police of several foreign nationals in the raid, but the PNP denies that allegation, saying maximum tolerance was implemented during the operation.